Good morning, students. I welcome you back. Today we are taking the new topic, topic called valuation of goodwill. How we value goodwill and what's the different types, different types of calculation of goodwill. But before we go for valuation, first you need to understand what is goodwill all about. As people know that goodwill is reputation, goodwill is intangible assets, these are characteristics. But how? What is goodwill actually? You know that people say that goodwill is an intangible asset. It's mentioned in the book also. Goodwill is an intangible asset? And why we treat it as an asset? You know, what is asset is? Assets are those which helps in business to earn more and more profit. Certainly, goodwill also helps us to earn more and more profit. Because goodwill generates a reputation in the market. And that reputation helps customers to go visit again and again to the particular business because he's earning a same amount of some amount of respect in the business or some amount of valuation in the business. Now, suppose I'm describing the goodwill with the help of a small example. Let's say there are five traders. There are five traders doing engaging in cloth business, retailing of the cloth business in a particular area, in the same area. Let's take we take the area of Chandni Chowk, Delhi. We get five traders out there. The first trader named Ram. Ram is a very old trader in Chandni Chowk, Delhi. I'm just taking an example. His profit is, he's earning a profit of rupees 12 lakh in a year. I'm just giving an example. He's a very old trader over there. He's a very old businessman located in Chandni Chowk. He's earning a profit of rupees 2 lakh. Another trader named Mohan. Is earning lesser amount of profit than Ram, but he's again an old businessman. Again an old businessman earning 10 lakh rupees. He's earning 12 lakh. He's earning 10 lakh rupees as a profit. This is another trader called Shiva. He's earning 6 lakh rupees as a profit. Again, these are the old businessmen located in Chandni Chowk and they are doing a cloth retailing market. Okay, they engage in cloth business, retail business. And there's a new businessman named Anil. He recently joined the business, say 1 year before. He recently joined a business, same business, a year before. And he's earning, from last 1 year, he's earning 3 lakh rupees as a profit. That is clear? Ram is the oldest one. He's earning a 12 lakh rupees profit. Mohan, not as old as Ram, but he is still doing the business in Chandni Chowk from long back. Shiva, not as old as Mohan and Ram, but earning 6 lakh rupees of profit. And Anil, who recently joined, just abhi joined kiya. Let's see, ek saal pehle. Year before, and he is earning a profit of rupees 3 lakh. Not clear? Now, this 3 lakh, because the market says that, and Chandni Chowk is a very big area, it's a huge area, so a lot many customers are visited to them. It means that Ram, Mohan, Shiva, Anil, Anil ne business naya shuru kiya, so customer to uske paas aa rahe because usne bhi business shuru kiya, retail market hai. तो जो लोग राम की यहाँ पर इनको टाइम नहीं मिल पा रहा होगा, दे आर विजिटिंग टू अनिल आल्सो एंड सम पीपल आल्सो ट्राई यार बहुत पुराना बहुत ट्राई कर लिया कुछ नए को भी ट्राई करते हैं हो सकता है तो राम इज अनिल इज अर्निंग अ कंसिडरेबल अमाउंट ऑफ प्रॉफिट से 3 लाख रुपीज एज एन ही इज अ न्यू बिजनेसमैन तो दिस 3 लाख इज अ नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट दिस 3 लाख इज अ नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट बट एक्स्ट्रा राम इज अर्निंग बिकॉज राम इज अर्निंग एक्स्ट्रा रुपीज 9 लाख And Mohan is earning extra rupees 7 lakh. Shiva is earning extra rupees suppose 3 lakh. So these are their profit which are generated through goodwill, through their reputation. And that amount of profit is called super profit. It's called super profit, which we going to learn in this valuation of goodwill part. Now, I hope you understand this thing. Extra, the amount of extra. Because Ram is a very old businessman over there. वो बहुत पुराना है, तो उसकी कुछ reputation है. And that reputation he earns, ठीक है, by working hard from last few years. इट्स नॉट लाइक कि इस आने ही इज गेटिंग अ गुडविल रिसेंटली ओनली और उसने गुडविल एकदम बना ली. उसको वो गुडविल बनाने में बहुत मेहनत लगी है और वो कंसीडर बहुत पुराना बिजनेसमैन है, तो उसकी रेपुटेशन बन के आई है कि भाई यू ऑलवेज सैटिस्फाइड द रीसेंट टेस्ट ऑफ कंज्यूमर, गुड्स अच्छा है. दिस ऑल थिंग्स हैव बीन अर्निंग रेपुटेशन, द सेम अमाउंट ऑफ रेपुटेशन अर्न बाय मोहन, बट नॉट एज कंपेयर टू राम, स्लाइटली लेसर देन, बट ही इज अ ओल्ड बिजनेसमैन ओवर देयर. अर्निंग द एक्स्ट्रा अमाउंट, द नॉर्मल रेट ऑफ प्रॉफिट इन बिजनेस इज 3 लाख, व्हिच अर्निंग इज गोइंग टू गेट इज अर्निंग द एक्स्ट्रा 3 लाख इज कॉल्ड सुपर प्रॉफिट. इज द क्लियर नाउ? तो ये नॉर्मल प्रॉफिट मींस नॉर्मल रेट ऑफ रिटर्न क्या चल रहा है बिजनेस में, दैट्स नॉर्मली द बिजनेस विल अर्न, द न्यू बिजनेस विल अर्न, एंड द एक्स्ट्रा द ओल्ड बिजनेसमैन दोज वी आर अर्निंग एक्स्ट्रा, दैट्स कॉल्ड सुपर प्रॉफिट. आई होप इट्स क्लियर. नाउ हाउ वी डिफाइन गुडविल, व्हाट इज द बेसिक पार्ट, हाउ वी डिफाइन गुडविल. फॉर द सेम यू नीड टू नोट डाउन डेफिनेशन, व्हाट इज गुडविल ऑल अबाउट. तो गुडविल your is intangible asset, but I'm writing a definition which is prescribed by AS 26, Accounting Standard 26, which you're going to learn. So goodwill is, now what is goodwill is? Goodwill is an intangible asset which places an enterprise at an advantageous position due to which enterprise is able to earn high profits without putting extra efforts. Please note down the definition. What is goodwill? Intangible asset which places an enterprise or business at an advantageous position due to which an enterprise or business is able to earn high profits without putting extra efforts. Because we call it naam bolta hai, the name itself speaks. Means goodwill creates brand name, goodwill creates that efforts by which you can earn a considerable amount of profit without putting extra efforts, because your name speak. In some locality, in every locality, in every city, there are some names are there which are very popular. Say for the street food, say for the clothing brands, say for anything. There are some names are there which speaks. Okay, their name itself speaks. For example, in Dehradun, this name place called name called Kumar Sweet Shop. The Kumar Sweet Shop is a name. It's a very famous brand in Dehradun. The name speak. Same for the bakery boards, BK Ajanta's, the name called Aurora's in Dehradun is very famous for their bakery boards, the pastries, patties. So their name speaks. The people are trust them because they are very old businessmen in Dehradun. So they are earning a considerable amount of profit in spite of their lot made net throat cutthroat competition is there in Dehradun in terms of bakery boards. But their name itself speaks. You find the queue there. You find लोगों की भीड़ होती है वहां पर, they want to purchase because their name is here, they create a brand name. So goodwill is what they say, that enterprise is able to earn high profits without putting extra efforts. हम सो जानते हैं ना, कहीं पर किसी जगह के छोले भटूरे बहुत फेमस हैं, किसी जगह के वैसे दही भल्ले बहुत फेमस हैं, तो हम बोलते हैं भाई अगर लखनऊ जाओगे तो शर्मा की चाय पी के आना, हम लखनऊ जाओगे तो टुंडे कबाब खा के आना. दिस नेम्स, दिस क्रिएट्स अ गुडविल, दैट्स अ गुडविल इज ऑल अबाउट. Because they are very old businessmen over there, from their past efforts, they work hard in their past, and they're still working hard, but they create a brand name, and that brand name speaks for them. And that how they create the brand name? Through mouth publicity. Because log jante hain unko, and that create a mouth publicity among locality. That's create the goodwill. Sorry. I hope you understand. So what are the features of goodwill? It is an intangible asset. It has realizable value when business sold. Now, when you sold your business, but God forbid, you want to sold your business and you are moving abroad, you want to sold a business in India. So, suppose your business value is 10 lakh and your goodwill value, say, bhai, humne naam kamaya hai, I want to sell my business to 15 lakh. But the other business say, bhai, your asset value is only 10 lakh rupees. But asset value, land, building value is 10 lakh. But I am... my image is here, my brand name is here, and that name should be, I'm selling it to 15 lakh more than the amount of assets. So that's extra money you're receiving, or that some other is paying. That's called goodwill. It has a realizable value when business is sold. It helps in earning high profits. You know that? It is an attractive force which brings customer required to the regularly to the place of business. Because when you brand name, when you create your brand name of the business, the people regularly visit your place because of your brand name. They say, yeah, pastry us shop ki bahut achhi hai. Maine kha ke dekhi, it's a good one. The taste is different. The taste is better. So that's creates a brand name among the people, those who visit regularly to the particular business. Again, one of the most important features is value of goodwill. One more you write, fifth point, value of goodwill depends upon value of goodwill. Note down please, value of goodwill depends upon subjective judgment of person. Depends upon subjective, depends upon subjective judgment of person. Judgment of person. Now what that means? Subjective, depend upon subjective judgment of person. Now for example, I'm taking a small example over here. Suppose Mr. Mukesh set up a factory. Here, this plant, he set up a factory. He set up a factory. He need this land. Unko is land ki zarurat hai. Yahan par Mukesh ka land hai. The land of Mukesh is here. Mukesh is residing over here. So business need this land in order they can set up a new factory or they can extend the factory. So they say, Mukesh, please sell this land to us. Mukesh say, now the cost of this land is 15 lakhs suppose. Ye jo land ki cost hai is of 16 lakh. The owner of this land is Mukesh. The cost of land is 15 lakh. But Kami say, Mukesh, please provide us land. Hame ye land bhej do. We will pay you 25 lakh rupees. Manna, why are they paying 10 lakh rupees extra? The company is ready to purchase this land for 25 lakh. Now, company knows that because this land is important for the business, we can increase it or we can extend the factory. That's important. It means it depends upon. Value of goodwill depends upon subjective judgment of person. It depends subjectively because for this particular thing, Mr. Ram. So Mukesh, take permission from Ram. Yeah, okay, if you want to sell this land to us, it's important for us. We can pay you extra. The cost of this land is, market value of this land is 15 lakh, but we are ready to pay 25 lakh. So extra 10 lakh rupees, Mr. Mukesh is paying to Ram. Why? Because of the goodwill. And that's what I'm saying. Goodwill is depends upon subjective judgment of person. I hope this is clear. Next part. Note down please. Now types of goodwill. As per accounting standard 26, which you're going to learn in partnership, goodwill is basically two types. First one is called purchase goodwill. We talk about the same. We talk about the same here. First, understand self-generated goodwill. Now, there are two types of goodwill. One, the purchase goodwill and the self-generated goodwill. Now, what is purchase goodwill? You understand a term which you're going to purchase. Now, suppose you take the franchisee of McDonald's. It means that you need your land, you need the workforce, you need everything. But you have to pay McDonald's a fees of their name because you are opening a restaurant, take a McDonald's restaurant in your locality or a particular area which is on agreement basis, but you are taking the name of McD. No, the McD cannot grant you name free, of course. They say, well, you are taking our name, you have to pay price for it. The price for McDonald's, only the name of McDonald's, this you are paying extra money apart from land, labor, workforce. You are paying the extra money that for the name only. Ab jis naam ke liye paisa kharch karo, that's called purchase goodwill. The example, if you ask Tendulkar, Sachin Tendulkar, I want to open a restaurant in your name. The restaurant already there in Mumbai. So they will say, of course, you take my name, but listening, for taking the name of Tendulkar or any famous celebrity, you have to pay the price of their name. And that you're paying price for the name is called purchase goodwill. Because you are using the name of a celebrity. Now, kisi celebrity ke naam se koi restaurant khol raha, you take permission of the celebrity and you need to pay the money by taking his name only. Aap uska naam apne restaurant ke upar laga raho. This is a Tendulkar restaurant or Ganguly or Rahul Dravid, whatever, or Virat Kohli. If you are using the name of any celebrity with his permission and you have to pay money to them, that's called purchase goodwill. One more example. Suppose ABC want to purchase a business of XYZ. ABC want to purchase a business of XYZ. The cost of XYZ businesses, they're listening very carefully. The cost of XYZ businesses is 10 lakh. We call net worth. Net worth. Now, how we calculate net worth? Net worth means, when I write net worth, the NW is asset minus liabilities. What are the business assets having? Yes, deduct liability from this, you get net worth. Kya mein jayegi? Net worth. Now, ABC, suppose the net worth of the XYZ business is 10 lakh and ABC want to purchase for 12 lakh. Actual cost of business is 10 lakh and ABC want to purchase this business for 12 lakh. This 12 lakh is called purchase consideration, which we have to study in shares in detail or in debentures also. In issue shares and issue debentures in later subjects. But PC is called purchase consideration. Agreed price. Jis keemat pe ABC want to purchase a business of XYZ. So he want to purchase a business for rupees 12 lakh. But the actual net worth of the business is 10 lakh. So how much money XYZ is paying extra? 2 lakh. This 2 lakh is called goodwill, purchase goodwill. I hope it's clear there. It's called purchase goodwill. The other example being, if you see, if you want to purchase a flat for a residential purpose or for a business purpose. Now, if you take in the city, the same square feet area of flat, suppose you want to purchase a 2000 square feet area. To get 2000 square feet, a flat of 3 BHK of 2000 square feet outside the city, it costs you slightly lesser as compared to if you take in within the city only. So this means the money you are paying extra is called goodwill. I hope it's clear now. Next part, I say, what is the need for valuation of goodwill? What is the need? Oh, sorry. Next we take self-generated goodwill. This goodwill is not purchased, rather than it is created by the efforts of management or by favorable condition. This goodwill is not recorded as an asset. Important point. As in partnership, accounting standard only says that goodwill can be recorded in the books when it was purchased. Please note down, goodwill can be recorded in the books, especially in partnership, when it was purchased or when you pay money for it. I hope you're clear. You pay money for it. But the self-generated goodwill, because it's a simple term, yeh mehnat ki koi keemat nahi hoti. A business hai, he creates a self-generated goodwill. Usne apna brand name khud banaya hai. For example, koi hawker hai, theek hai, is selling a dahi wale. To usne usko khud naam laya. Log jante hain usko bhi. He is selling a very good dahi wala. It's very famous in their patle, locality. But this is self-generated goodwill. This goodwill is not purchased, rather than it is created by the efforts of management or by favorable conditions. Please note down. This goodwill is not recorded as an asset. So which goodwill is recorded? The purchase goodwill. Okay, for which we are paying the money. I hope it's clear. Note down the same. There are two types of goodwill. We are studying accounting standard 26. Purchase goodwill and the self-generated goodwill. So these things are clear to you. Next part is, why we need for valuation of goodwill. Note down the same. Why we need valuation of our goodwill. Now here we are taking, what is the need for valuation of goodwill? We study our types of goodwill. The first one is the goodwill which we purchase, and the second thing is the goodwill which self-generated. Next thing is, what is the need for valuation of goodwill? Why do we need goodwill value? Now, goodwill, need for beneficial goodwill occur when there is a change in profit-share ratio. Now what it means? Suppose there are three partners sharing ratio in the ratio of 3:2:1. And then they have changed their profit-share ratio. They change their partnership agreement, or with the help of this, they change their profit-share ratio. When they change their profit-share ratio, we have to value the goodwill. The first thing is, when there is a change in profit-share ratio, when admission of a partner, when a new partner admits the business, then in order, when new partner admit, we need to value the goodwill. Same for retirement and death of a partner. When partnership firm is sold, when you sold your partnership firm, what extra price you are selling it, you need to value your goodwill. When two firms take a merge together, when two firms combine together, when firm is converted into a company. So these are the cases when there is a need for valuation of goodwill. Now, in board examination, it's very important question for 1 marks as well as 3 marks. They say, what is the need for valuation of goodwill? Except this. You need to find out, calculate the value of goodwill apart from changing profit-share ratio, apart from admission, or apart from retirement. So generally, what the student does, they study the first 3. And the question says that, apart from these 3, so all are important. So it's my humble request to all the students, please understand in term. You cannot forget 1-2 lines in that. The question can be asked in any way. So when partnership firm is sold, again, you need to calculate the goodwill. When two firms amalgamate, when two firms join together, when firm is converted into a company, you need to value the goodwill. I hope this is clear. Next part is, understand then, what is the factor which affect the value of goodwill? Factors that affects the value of goodwill. Factors affecting value of goodwill. Value of goodwill. What are the different factors which affect the value of goodwill? The first one is, you know, favorable location. Of course, if the location is favorable. Favorable location. If the location is favorable, of course, the goodwill will increase. The first thing is favorable location. Next thing is longer establishment. Third part is efficient management, important part. Efficient management. If the management is efficient, he can make the employee comfortable, happy, then only the business will flourish. And when the business will flourish, then only the business can earn money, create goodwill. And when they create goodwill, the more amount of profit is there. So please remember efficient management. Next part is quality of good. Again, it's important point. Quality. What type of quality of good you are offering to the market? If the quality of good is good, then of course it creates a brand name. And when the brand name created, then it offers goodwill. Quality of good. Apart from this thing, market situation. You also write market situation. Then after sales services. There are various points are there which can affect the value of goodwill. So these are the factors which affecting value of goodwill. Favorable location, longer establishment, efficient management, quality of good, after sales services. If you want a better sales after sales services, it's happened the ticket, electronic market, car market. The company which provide the better sales services, the students always attract towards them. So these are things which can affect the value of goodwill. Now next part, we are doing the coming to numerical portion. Before that, you need to understand what are the different methods for valuation of goodwill. How we calculate goodwill. Understand them. There are 4 methods which prescribed in partnership. 3 out of them are in India syllabus. Valuation of goodwill. Valuation of goodwill. First one is average profit method. Second one is weighted average profit method.
we provide the weightage also. Next is super profit method, and the next one is capitalization method.
You see, I describe also what is super profit, the profit which is more than the normal amount. I teach you in the beginning of this lecture, super profit, capitalization method, these are four methods given in the question. We are taking the average profit first. How we calculate average profit? Now, normally students think that this is a very easier part. Goodwill is equal to average profit into number of your purchase. Of course, it's easy. But always, there are certain amounts of the errors are there in average profit which you need to find out. A lot of students have made mistake in that, and this is an important part. Normally, frequently, the questions from in class 12 accountancy are asked from this particular method. So, because it's easy also, but normally the students make mistake. So, what is average profit? I'm just giving a brief term. Now, average profit, suppose a business in 2015, 2016, in 2017, 2018, 2019, they're earning the same type of business, earning 1 lakh as a profit. Here is earning 1,50,000. Here is earning 2 lakh. Is earning 2,20,000. Is earning 2,50,000 as a profit. Now, there are certain items. In a kuch aise items hogi which are errors. Now, what are the errors? Suppose there are some amount of profit there. Some amount of expensive which is a revenue expenditure, but mistakenly you could take it as a capital expenditure. Suppose you have machine nahi purchase ki, aapne isko purchase mein dal diya, to you decrease the profit. The machine nahi purchase kahan par aana chahiye, it should be come under asset side. It's not a revenue expenditure, it's a capital expenditure, and vice versa. To means these are error occur, to business bolta hai ye error dobara nahi hona chahiye. To hame kya karna padega, we need to identify these errors. Or these errors should be removed. So how we calculate average profit, this is the important part. So listen the formula or listen the method very carefully, so that okay, when you attempt the question, there are no chance of errors here, and you get awarded full marks. So what is the first thing, how we calculate average profit? Note down average profit, or how we calculate average profit. First thing is, the formula of valuation is average profit. We are doing by average profit. The formula here is, goodwill is calculated average profit into number of years of purchase. The student knows it. What is the average profit? But they memorize it. What is number of year of purchase? This is a 3, 4, 5. What it means 3, 4, 5? Note down this thing. Number of year of purchase means number of year of purchase means important point. Number of year of purchase means for how many years? For how many years the business will earn? Write down for how many years. Years the business will earn on the same amount of profit, the same amount of profit for how many years the business will earn the same amount of profit. Understand this? Without putting extra efforts, without putting extra efforts. Extra efforts, or in simple way we can say that how many years in next coming years the business will earn the profit, or business will earn the profit by his name only. Apne naam ki wajah se usse kitni aur kitne saal tak profit ho sakta hai. So these are things, because goodwill is always calculated for the future prospects, and it used to be at least calculated from the past year profits. You understand this thing? Goodwill is calculated for the future prospects. Okay, and it is calculated for the past year profits. So it's important to know that. For how many years the business will earn the profit, the same amount of profit, without putting the extra efforts. I hope you understand this thing. So this is the number of year purchase mean. The goodwill is calculated average profit into number of year purchase. Average profit means total profit. How we calculate average profit? Total profit upon number of years of profit is given. Suppose you are calculating for 5 years. The 5 year profit is here. So add the 5 years profit, divide by 5, you get the average profit. Now important part is how we calculate the profit. How we calculate the profit. Now I'm adding a very simple formula for this thing. How we calculate profit is an important one because there are not many errors at the end in profit. So how we remove them. So note down this thing, how we calculate profit. For this, I need to rub the board so that I can write the formula clearly and you can able to note down and understand it in a very significant manner so that no chance of errors here. So first note down how we calculate profit. In profit, suppose sometime when the profit is given, we need to add abnormal losses. Abnormal losses. Now what is abnormal losses? Those losses which cannot be occur frequently. Okay, suppose loss by fire, loss by theft, ye har baar to nahi honge na. Agar humne isko profit mein se minus kar rakha hai, we need to add them because it's not a normal course of business. Goods lost by fire, ya goods lost by theft, so these are called abnormal losses. We need to add them. So what we write? Loss of goods by fire or theft, loss of goods by fire or oblique theft. Next is other type of things here. You pay interest paid, dividend paid is not a normal course of business. Need to add them because you already subtracted. Important point, add over valuation of opening stock. Now important point, you're studying in class 11 how what is opening stock means and how it's evaluated. We need the opening stock in calculation of cost of goods sold. Now if you overvalue opening stock, agar aapne opening stock ki value ko jyada measure kar liya, to it will decrease your profit because the more stock is using in business, it increases the cost of goods sold, and the cost of goods sold increases, it will decrease the gross profit, and the gross profit decreases, similarly the net profit also decreases. So means overvaluation of opening stock, agar aapne overvaluation ko opening stock ko overvalued kar rakha hai, to you need to less than. So add overvaluation of opening stock. Oh, I think if you overvaluation of opening stock, yes. Do you cost of goods sold hamara badh gaya, a cost of goods sold hamara increase ke to profit hamara kam ho gaya, and if hamara profit kam ho gaya to hamara net profit bhi kam hoga. You understand them? Overvaluation of opening stock, jab humne opening stock ko overvalue kar liya, suppose the opening stock is 10,000, by mistake we overvalued is 20,000. So if we increase the value of opening stock, our cost of goods sold will increase, and the cost of goods sold will increase, then definitely our gross profit decreases, same as net profit. So for rectifying this error, we need to add them. Simply add undervaluation of closing stock. Undervaluation of closing stock. Now, if you decrease the value of closing stock, again your profit decreases. So you undervalue the closing stock. The closing stock value is 50, but by mistake you write 40. So it will decrease your gross profit. If the gross profit decreases, same the net profit also decreases. So in order to rectify it, we need to add them. So undervaluation of closing stock. One more important thing is when capital expenditure is treated as revenue expenditure.
when capital expenditure is treated as
revenue expenditure. Again, in that case, means you purchase a machinery, and instead of recording machinery account, you recording purchase account. You decrease the amount of gross profit. Again, some say you need to rectify it, because when you purchase machinery, it should be recorded in machinery account, not in purchase account. I hope it's clear. Now, same way, there are certain thing item which you deducted or which added to your balance sheet, you need to rectify. So, really, less abnormal gains if credited. Please mention if credited. Agar already credited ho chuke hain, if debited here. If already debited ho chuke hain. Abnormal gains, like you receive the insurance claim. Insurance claim received. Now you receive the insurance claim. Insurance claim is not a regular income. You receive an insurance claim, it's not a regular income. Are you understand that? So it means you need to rectify the error, you need to deduct it. Because you already created, it increased the profit, you already increased the profit. So in order to find the actual profit, you need to subtract it. In a way, suppose your interest paid and dividend paid, less interest received and dividend received. Similarly, opposing, if overvaluation opening stock will be added here, undervaluation of opening stock. Similarly, overvaluation of closing stock. Overvaluation of closing stock. Overvaluation of closing stock. And then in the same way, I need to rub this. If revenue expenditure is treated as, if revenue expenditure is treated as capital expenditure, now same way, you paid rent but it's forgotten to be recorded as you paid rent and it should be recorded in machinery account. Again, wrong thing. Or I hope you understand. See, if revenue expenditure treated as capital expenditure, you need to subtract it. And next is partner remuneration. Partner's salary. We call partner's remuneration. Partner's remuneration, or we say partner's salary, if it is not deducted. If it is partner remuneration, we have to pay partner remuneration. If it is not deducted, we need to deduct it. So I hope it's clear how we calculate profit. So this is a way by which we can calculate the profit. To understand the formula, because if you understand this formula, your chances of getting full marks is here, because this part is very important. How we calculate average profit. So this is clear now, how we calculate average profit. Next part is, I'm taking a very small question over here, so that you can able to understand where and how this formula is applicable, or this method is applicable. I'm taking a very short question over here. Note down the thing. Question number one I'm taking over. Goodwill is valued at 3-year purchase of 4-year average profit. Now again, goodwill, I'm writing the question in a very short manner. Goodwill is valued at 3-year purchase of 3-year purchase of Goodwill is valued at 3-year purchase of 4-year average profit. Of 4-year average profit. Now listen here. 3-year purchase of 4-year average profit. It means the 4-year profit is given to us.
Now note down the amount. What is the 4-year profit?
Say in 2016, the business is earning 12,000 rupees. In 2017, the business is earning 18,000 rupees. In 2019, the business in 2017 in 18, the business is earning 16,000 rupees. In 2019, it will be earning 14,000. Okay. Now find the total profit. Calculate total profit. Add them. If you add them, it's 60,000. The average profit is 60,000 divided by 4. You get 15,000. And goodwill is measured. What's the formula of goodwill? Average profit multiplied by number of year of purchase. Number of years of purchase, which is 15,000 multiplied by 3, has come 45,000 rupees. I hope this is clear. Note down if you have any doubt. 4-year profit is given. Find profit is total 60,000. Average divided by 4, you get 15,000. The goodwill is average profit into number of year purchase, which is 45,000. The things clear? Okay. Now, take another question. Suppose, same way, you have to calculate the value of goodwill on the basis of 3-year purchase average profit of preceding 3-year purchase of 5-year. The question is saying goodwill is valued 3-year purchase of average profit. Of average profit of preceding 5 years, of preceding 5 years. Now 5 year profit is given. 5 years. I hope you understand the question. Goodwill is valued at 3 year purchase of average profit of preceding 5 years. Now preceding 5 years, they say that in 2018 and 19, suppose they say the profit is 8 lakh. Okay? In 2017, 18, it means that is given as 15 lakh. Then, 2000, we write here, 16, 17, it's given as 18 lakh. In this case, the profit is decreasing. Wow, what a question is. In 2015-16, there's a loss of 4 lakh rupees here. Now, there's a loss of 4 lakh. So, we need to write in bracket. It's mentioned here, loss of 4 lakh. Here is a loss of 4 lakh. And in 2014 and 15, again, there's a profit of rupees 30 lakh. Oh, the question is clear to you. Okay, goodwill is value of 3-year purchase of average profit of preceding 5 years. Now, the 5-year profit is given to us. We need to find out goodwill. Now, how we calculate goodwill? In this same, only difference is loss is here. Rest, everything is same. Only loss is here. So, how we add the profit, divide the loss. Because loss is already here. You need to add all this, get the loss. The total profit you get is, calculate please, 13, 23, 31, 41, 44 minus 4. I hope it's getting 50 lakh. Check again. 23, 31, 41, 41 plus 13, 54 minus 4, 50. The average profit from you get 50 lakh. Average profit is 50 lakh divided by 5 is 10 lakh, and we will say that goodwill is valued at 3-year purchase. The goodwill is going to 10 lakh
Mandalapatri, you get 30 lakh as the amount of goodwill. You get 30 lakh as the amount of goodwill.
I hope this is clear. How we calculate? So this is a simple formula. In my next lecture, I will take complex form of average profit, in which multiple errors are given, and we try to learn super profit method as well as capitalization method. So till then, stay safe, stay at home, stay healthy, take care.